It seems like there's always some kind of soccer event, some kind of football event going on somewhere around the world. Sorry, the American was coming out of me there for a second. There's this UEFA thing. There's this Champions League thing. There's La Liga. There's Bundesliga. There's the French one and the Italian one that I don't know how to pronounce. There's World Cups and World Plates. Maybe World Plate, the plate thing is a tennis thing. I can't remember. I don't follow that much of it. But it's a big deal. I know that. Everybody seems to love it. And of all the balls that are out there, maybe the most aesthetically pleasing ball is the soccer ball, the football, as it would be called. And for that reason, we're going to make the football in Adobe Illustrator. And the techniques that we use are pretty cool. I think you're going to love them. It's going to be a fast tutorial. So grab a drink, hang on tight. We're going to fly through kind of an older, more classic football, and then kind of a more modern style, the one that everybody's seen. Let's jump into Illustrator and take a look at it and learn some fun and fast techniques. Here we are in Illustrator. I've got a 2560 by 1440 document. If you need your own document, of course, file new. 2560 by 1440. You know it. You love it. That's what we're going with here. And I just threw some kind of just quick warmish background back there. It begins with the ellipse tool. Click a single time and we are going to make a 300 pixel by 300 pixel ellipse and drop it in the center of our document. We're going to get rid of the white fill. So we're just going to hit the little slash icon. I'm going to select to bring the black as my foreground color, or not, just bring the stroke to the foreground, I should say. It's not the foreground color, it's just the stroke color. And we're going to come over here to our stroke panel and we'll increase the size to, I don't know, 10 points, something that we can see. Then we will align this to the center of our artboard, just vertically, horizontally, the whole deal, at just like that. Now we're going to make two copies of this ellipse, just one at a time here. So we're going to go Command-C and Command-F to just paste in front. You can see here in our layers panel, we have two of these ellipses now. We're going to go over here to our Properties panel, and I'm just going to multiply this by 1.5. So just asterisk 1.5, and I have my width and height linked together because I've selected that little link icon. And bing, cool. And now I'm going to select that center ellipse again, Command or Control C, Command or Control F to paste that in front. I'm going to drag it up to the top to make sure it's really, really in front. And then we're going to multiply this by 2. So asterisk 2, and we have the three ellipses that we want. I take that back. We actually need another ellipse, which is actually going to be the base of our ball. I'm going to grab that middle ellipse again. We're going to go ahead and use the transform option here, move, and we are going to move it not along the horizontal axis, but along the vertical axis. We're just going to push it downward 150 pixels. 150 pixels, of course, is half of 300, and 300 pixels was the diameter of our original ellipse. And here I'm going to press the copy button so we get a copy of that ellipse. So this is the base of our shape here. Now, this outer ellipse, it's just kind of like there as a guide ellipse. It takes 2 seconds to create it, so I did. We can actually get rid of that, and I'll do that right now by just selecting and deleting it. This is really the base of our shape. We have these two rings that we're going to move around the center of what's actually going to be our ball. But in order to know where these rings need to go, we need to create kind of a guide. And the easiest way to do this is by creating a triangle. So go in here and grab the star tool, click a single time, and the radius 1 and 2, make them whatever you want. I just leave it as it is. But the important thing here is just a three-pointed star. And a three-pointed star, of course, is just a triangle. I'm going to take this triangle, and this is where you can use Illustrator to your advantage and really do some fun stuff. Up here under the view menu, we want to make sure we have smart guides turned on. Very important. It's going to make your life, it's going to make what would have been horrible, not quite so horrible. In fact, pretty easy. So I'm going to take this, and we can actually select these two outer ellipses here, and we can just group them together, Command or Control G, and you can see now it's that group, and I'm gonna hit the little eyeball icon, and I'm gonna hide them for just a minute here so we don't mess them up or get confused. I'm gonna take this triangle, and you can see the smart guides are saying like, hey, you're aligned right to the center of the circle. Well, what I wanna do is I wanna align the top point. See, that's an anchor point up there. I wanna align that anchor point with this actual path. So I'm gonna drag this straight upward until it just kind of clicks. Then I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to pull the triangle down this way. And I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to pull the triangle down this way. And what I'm looking to do is just get these anchor points on the corners of the triangle to kind of click down onto this path where it comes through, well, just where the path is. So I'm just going to hold down shift and I'm going to fuss around with this and mess around with it. I'll keep kind of clicking it back into place and you can keep playing with it. You'll feel it kind of click when it goes. It takes a little bit of fussing with it, but it's worth the effort and it'll happen for you. And as long as you're relatively close, it's going to be a good enough guide. So that's the guide there. Let's turn on our outermost group. Remember, I said this is a guide. So with this group now, we're going to duplicate the group. So I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key and just drag a copy of it out. All right. We can select this and move it around in just a moment. The idea here is we want the leftmost edge of the outer ring to align with the leftmost side of our triangle, while we have our inner ring intersect with this junction right up here. So that kind of top junction. But you can see how our outer ring aligns pretty much with that angle of the triangle. And you can kind of fuss things and move things around if need be. Now I'm going to duplicate this by holding on Alt or Option. I'm also going to hold down my Shift key and I'm just going to drag this straight across my screen toward the left until I feel it snap, because now we want that outer ring, that rightmost outer ring, to align with the right side of the triangle. And this complex looking series of what in the world's going on, this is how we're going to create our soccer ball, our football, I should say. I'm going to select that triangle and we're just going to get rid of it. So bing, delete, gone. We now have just this shape. From this, we're going to create the sort of retro football. It's really not that complicated. It's not that difficult. What I'm going to do is I'm going to ungroup everything by just selecting everything, object, ungroup. We got a bunch of lines and everything else. And we're going to go object group just to kind of keep it clean. And now we're going to use what's called the shape builder tool. The hotkey is shift M. And I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key and just drag through stuff I want to get rid of. And I know these three big circular areas on the outside I want to get rid of. Now, in order to make this an actual ball, I need to get rid of these triangles sticking out of the sides. So let's hold down our Alt or Option key again, drag through those bits, and we're going to get rid of them just like so. Cool. So now we have this. Now what we want to do is we want there to be this kind of striping effect. So we're just going to drag across the shapes that we want to make up the sort of panels of the ball. So just like that, we've created the base of our shape. Now there are a couple little wings sticking out there, things we need to clean up. Don't worry, we're gonna clean them up in just a second, but we have the base of the ball. And you can see how quickly that all kind of just came together. Now, because of the way this works and because of the way we did it, we have some random triangles in there. You can go through, I like to go through just kind of manually in my layers panel and just select them and delete them. Holding down shift, you can select multiple triangles at a time, just like this, boom. And you can get rid of all of those shapes just like that. And now we're just left with these six nice clean shapes just like so. And at this point, you can just, pop the old stroke width or stroke weight up a little bit. You can see we're getting some hooks and things like that. If you're getting hooks and things like that, you can select the word stroke and say like, hey, round off my joints and also maybe round caps. That should help clean up a lot of that kind of stuff where you may have some of that. But that's just a real quick and easy way to create that initial classic football icon shape in Adobe Illustrator using just a couple shapes. Now we're going to move on to creating the more recognizable soccer or football shape here in Illustrator. I'm going to lock up this original group just to get it out of the way so I don't accidentally select it, delete it, destroy it, whatever. All right, this one begins again with the ellipse tool. Let's grab the ellipse. We're going to go with a 400 pixel ellipse like that. We're going to align this puppy to the center of our document as well. And now we're going to go ahead and grab the polygon tool. I'm going to click once. We're going to go with, let's go with like 70 pixels. We can make it bigger later, but let's start with 70. 60, 70, something like that should be good. Don't worry about strokes and all that nonsense. We're just going to go ahead and create our initial shape. In fact, you can select these and just align them together horizontally, vertically, all that good stuff. And now, this is also an area where having your smart guides turned on, it's really going to help you. Hold down Alt or Option. Make sure you're using your selection tool. The hotkey for that is the letter V. Hold down Alt or Option and just drag the shape straight up. And you can see, boom, the paths perfectly intersect just like so. And just like that. Cool. And we're going to do it going downward too. I want to go like 5 or 6 high. Just something where we can definitely cover the entire ball, and we know that we're gonna have enough kind of a pattern here. All right, what I wanna do, I'm gonna drag this ellipse shape up to the top. I just always like to have it on top for some reason, and I'm going to lock it because we need to be able to just drag a selection over all of our hex shapes so we can duplicate them and move them around. This is where things get a little, not tricky, but finicky. But if you do it the right way, it's not difficult at all. But it can be frustrating if you don't know about this little feature called Snap to Point. If we just take all of these hexagon shapes and hold down Alt or Option and duplicate the shape and say, hey, I've got some arc guides turned on. It's going to click right into those valleys, right? These shapes are going to click right together. They don't. You can see they try to align right there to the center point of the hex, and that's great, but I don't know exactly where, like side to side, I need to drop my row of hex shapes to get them to perfectly line up with the stroke. And we want to have some precision here. So here's what we're going to do. You're going to select your view menu, and you're going to turn on this option down here called Snap to Point. Now, the Snap to Point feature works when you use the direct selection tool. Not the regular selection tool, but the direct selection tool. Now, very important point here. When you are using Snap to Point and you're going to use the direct selection tool, make sure you have the group of graphics or the graphic that you want to move around fully selected first with the selection tool. So hit the letter V, grab your artwork, bing, and then grab the direct selection tool. Now we're gonna zoom in. The letter A gets us back to the direct selection tool, and you're gonna click right on the anchor point, or just one of the anchor points. You're gonna drag it, and you're gonna snap that one anchor point to the other anchor point, just like that. And that is Snap to Point. Now I'm gonna go back to my regular selection tool. I'm gonna copy out another chunk of shapes. I'm gonna zoom in. I'm gonna hit the letter A, grab that anchor point. I'm gonna move it in until I feel it click. Bada boom. Great, and then I'm going to repeat this process for the other side. I'm gonna grab all of the hexagonal shapes. I'm gonna hold down Alt or Option, drag it over this way, zoom in. All you have to do is grab one anchor point. We're gonna grab this one, move it in, we're gonna feel it click. There we go, and then we'll zoom back out. And at this point, we have this nice pattern, which will be our soccer ball or football pattern. What's next? Well, what I like to do is I like to fill them all so they're easier to select. So let's just fill them all with white because our ball is gonna be white. And we're gonna give them a stroke of, let's go with like 3 points, something much, much thinner than we've got now. Now, before I go grouping all this together, I want to select the pieces that are going to be black. So I'm gonna go black, black, and black here. And then what there seems to be with the soccer or the football is you have these point-to-point lines. They're the points that connect the sort of black shapes together. So let's do that, and let's fill these shapes that we've selected. It looks like we've selected who knows what right now, but I know what I've selected. And you'll see here when I fill it with black, we've selected those shapes just like that. And everything else can remain white. So you kind of have these stacks of two white hexagons on top of one another. And now that we've done that, we can select this whole kit and caboodle. Remember, we still have our original ellipse up here locked, so we're not selecting and damaging that. And we can group all this together, Command or Control G. And now you can see in the layers panel, we have this group, which is basically our football pattern. Now what we wanna do is select our outside or our top ellipse and duplicate it. Command or Control C, and then we can just go edit, paste in front. And we will select the rear or the bottom of the two ellipses and hold down shift. So you select that little circle icon there and then hold down shift and select the circle icon to select all of the ball pattern artwork. And then we're going to go object, clipping mask, make. The hotkey is command 7, that's control 7 on the PC. And we've limited our pattern to within just the ball. Now, the great thing about this is a couple things. Number one, you can open up that clipping group and you can just select the artwork and move it around. Because maybe it's like, hey, that's actually where we want it to be. Now notice we're running out of pattern up there. So maybe we actually want to move this up a little bit more like that. We want it to be something maybe like that. I don't know, whatever, it can be whatever. The other cool thing about this is you can select the group of hexagonal artwork and go Effect, Warp, and we're gonna choose Inflate. And I'm gonna give this kind of just the maximum of 100%. You can kind of give it whatever you want. If it looks like there's something that might be better, I'm gonna give it 100%, I'm gonna hit okay. And then we can still move this artwork around. Now these do admittedly look a little big, so I'm gonna hold down Alt or Option and the Shift key. And I'm gonna make this group a bit smaller so we can try to get more of these hexagonal shapes onto the ball. Maybe that's a little bit too many, something like that. Let's move it around until it kind of looks a little more proper. This is where you just, I mean, you fuss with it, make it your own, make it what you think it ought to be. Let's bring it down from the outside here. Something maybe kind of like that. And you can really just fuss with it and make the ball look exactly how you think it ought to look. You can pull it around, you can push it around, do all kinds of cool things with it. And really, the inflate effect, it's going to look better the more kind of rounded your group of hexagonal shapes is. So I kind of have this staggered offset rectangle look. If I got rid of some of this stuff up here and added a couple hexagons to the outside and the bottom, the inflation would probably look a little bit better, if I'm being honest here. But we can move it around. We can fuss with it and try to save. We can try to save it here. Maybe make it something sort of like that. I don't know. Maybe that doesn't quite look all that great either. I'm going to get picky with it here. Let's go with something kind of like, maybe kind of sort of like that. That's good enough. Doesn't quite look right. But again, like I said, if you get this shape a little bit more circular in terms of the way you lay out your hexes, the whole warp effect will apply a little bit differently because it has to do with the shape of the stuff that's being warped. And if you want to adjust that warp, by the way, you can come in here to the appearance panel, and there it is, warp inflate. Just click on it, and we could say like, hey, just kind of chill out there on that the bending effect. Or we could try something else. We could try a squeeze or a twist or other stuff that probably wouldn't work. Maybe the bulge. I don't know. You could try all kinds of different things. And see how they work for the ball. Actually, the bulge might work pretty well for us here. We could do that and drag that around a little bit. Yeah, I don't know. Looking a little funky, if I'm being honest. But maybe something like that. Whatever. Whatever it takes. You can fuss with your own artwork and adjust it. And it is all adjustable. You just have to come into that hex group and you can adjust that warp to your heart's delight. So that is it for this one, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to just drag this old school looking soccer ball here. By the way, you can go properties. We could bump this guy up to 400 pixels too, just like that. You can compare the two side by side, something like so. Or you could grab your magic wand tool and say, hey, don't select stroke weight, select fill color, select all the stuff that's filled with white, and get rid of that white fill and make the soccer ball a little bit more see-through. You could do something like that as well. A lot of different things you can do. Illustrator is, it can be clunky to work with at times, but it can also be incredibly powerful and allow you to go in and really change and tweak and adjust a lot of different things, even if it requires a couple additional steps that are a little annoying. But yeah, that's going to be it for this one, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you've enjoyed it, maybe learned a thing or two about the shape builder and playing around with shapes and effects and snap to point. That's a great little feature in Illustrator, very useful for doing any type of precision work where you're trying to line up paths and make sure everything just works. But yep, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you've learned a thing or two. Follow me on Instagram if you do the Instagram thing. Subscribe here on YouTube if you like to subscribe to people on YouTube. And until next time, thank you so much for watching. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one.